back. Very good reason why I played that today. Well, two very good reasons. But the first reason is, oh, some of you might not have got the memo what this channel's about. This channel's about fun. Yes, I will try and educate you a little bit, because I don't know everything. I may make the odd mistake. You may nitpick on certain things. Hey, I'm only human. But when it starts to get rude, you know, I've said before, just move on. If this is not your cup of tea,
excuse me.
Actually, that's quite apt, the next track, isn't it? If you don't like what you see here, then please, you know, no one's forcing you to watch. But when you put derogatory comments, because that's one thing I've never been, is rude about any of my viewers, and I never would be, because believe it or not, you know, one, I do this for myself because I really enjoy to do it, but two, I do it for the many subscribers that, well, I say many, but I've jumped up considerably from where I was when I started to take this a bit more seriously. But I've made some really good friends, and there's lots and lots of people that have given me nothing but 100% support. But every now and again, you're going to get, you know, the people that are not happy, or they just want to put you down. But like I say, if this is not for you, you know, if you want to put thumbs down, if you want to put derogatory comments, then, you know, eventually I will just block them, because there's no need for it. You know, if ever I've not liked something on YouTube, I don't put a thumbs down, I don't put derogatory comments, I just leave it and I go somewhere else. You know, and you know, it's not everybody. Please believe me, I've got some brilliant, brilliant subscribers. Anyway, that's enough about that. Today, I want to talk to you about Elsie's RCA Camden releases. Now, I've been thinking about this now for a little while to do, and I want you to change direction from where I've been. Now, Camden officially was known as the budget label of RCA Victor. It was formed in 1953. Now, its sole purpose was to reissue 78s that were no longer available. Now, the reason it's called Camden, Camden is in New Jersey, obviously United States, and that's where RCA had their offices, I think since 1901, hence why RCA Camden. Now, the very first, I've had to make some notes on this because there's quite a few records, and I didn't realise there was this many. If you look at Wikipedia, for example, which I don't like to get some of my information from that because some of it can be incorrect. They're saying that the first Elvis release on Camden was 1968. I beg to differ on that. I think it was 1969. Now, it was June 1969. Now, if anyone has any difference of opinion that is contrary to that, and please let me know, you know, because we are here to learn from one another. And that's what I've always maintained, that, you know, I don't know everything. Yes, I've been an Elvis fan for, well, for those of you who ask how old I am, 48 now, and I've been an Elvis fan for probably 48 of those years. So, but anyway, going back to the very first release, Elvis sings Flaming Star. Now, this was on the RCA International, and you can see Camden written there. That would be the first time that Camden would appear on any record label for Elvis Presley. Now, what's very interesting about this record is that it had an unreleased track on it, Tiger Man. Now, bearing in mind, in April of 69, obviously this album that we're all familiar with was released, but there was no Tiger Man on it. And then 2 months later, to get Elvis Sings Flaming Star, and then we get Tiger Man on it. That was fantastic for us collectors, wasn't it? Camden, or RCA Camden, would have a habit of putting in little nuggets, little gems like that, for us to enjoy. So that would be the first one. Awesome cover. One of my favourite records. I've got the American one as well, which I think I've shown in a previous video. But there you can see, great shot. This would be reissued in April of 79 with a completely different cover. And this would be the first time that we would see, I'll come on to this later in the video, but from 1978, the label would just go over to Camden, the turquoise label we would all be familiar with. Now, the reason I thought about doing this video today is because I was asked a question in one of the comments about a week ago. Now, I think it was from Nancy, but I might be wrong on this, but please accept my apologies if it isn't. And if it is Nancy, I'll pop your name up on the screen. This is how I first got exposed to Elvis. Growing up as a small child in the 1970s, these were the albums that were readily available. Now, they were readily available from places like Woolworths, which unfortunately is no longer with us. And most of them used to be priced at around 99 pence. So they were very affordable. And the reason I know they were priced at 99 pence, I'll show you later, because I've got some original albums with the original price tickets on, which is great. So there you go, reissued in April of 79. As I say, completely different cover. If I'm honest, I prefer the original cover, as indeed this was completely different. But anyway, there you go, that was a reissue. We next get to November 1970, Elvis Almost in Love. You don't get better than that for an album cover now, do you? I think it's fabulous. Once again, we're sticking with the green, I suppose that you could call it lime green, the International Camden label. Yeah, good selection of songs on that. That's one of my favourite records, that. And then March 71, we would get to Elvis, You'll Never Walk Alone. Now, this would be the first release from RCA Camden on the blue label, but we would revert back to the green label for another two further presses. Now, why, I don't know, but if anyone knows the answer to that, then please let me know. But as I say, this is now to the blue turquoise. Now, in May of 72, this had an export cover that was done, which was completely different to anything else that we'd seen before. It wasn't readily available in the shops over here. As I say, it was mainly for export. There are a few copies around. I have had a copy of it. Unfortunately, I don't have it anymore. But it had the same cover as Elvis for Everyone, which I will show you. I have got that copy. Bear with me a moment while I quickly hunt it down. I should have been better prepared for this, shouldn't I? But there you go. That's what You'll Never Walk Alone, the export copy, looks like. Exactly the same cover. As I say, it's very, very hard to get hold of. And as I say, it was called You'll Never Walk Alone, but exactly the same cover. RCA and did some wonderful things during the 70s, as I'll show you later, with reissuing the same album twice in the same month. It was just, anyway, ludicrous. But there you have it. And next, excuse me while I do refer to my notes, there's quite a lot of information to retain on this. Next, we come to July 71. Come on, everybody. We are still at the lime green, RCA International, the green label. But there you go, what I was mentioned earlier about the price tickets, 99 pence. So as I say, you know, Camden was formed to be a budget label for RCA. And certainly here, at those kind of prices, they were very affordable to most people. What's next? And next we get to December 71. And as I was mentioned earlier, there would be quite, these would get released very rapidly over a short period of time. I got lucky, once again, 99 pence. And as I mentioned to you earlier, about the two further releases after You'll Never Walk Alone that had the blue label, we've had two further releases on the green International Camden label. And what's also good about these releases is that they were in proper mono and stereo releases. So that was absolutely perfect. And the sound on these sounds really good, particularly one I'll come to a little bit later. I think the sound on it is fantastic. These, as I say, they may have been budget LPs, but they didn't skimp on the sound, not in my opinion. I have actually missed one out. I missed out the opening track song, Change of Habit, which was from Let's Be Friends. Now, this came out originally in May 1970. I don't have the UK version, but this would be the second one on the RCA Camden label. But in 1975, RCA Camden leased the rights to the Camden releases to Pickwick. And then Pickwick would mainly re-release all of the Camden releases up to that point. But that would change because in 1977, obviously at the untimely passing of Elvis, there'd be an upsurge in record sales and RCA would relinquish back that lease. They would take it back from Pickwick and then they would start to release their own albums again. So as I say, the Pickwick wasn't around for too long because of that reason. But this is one of my favourite records. I should have mentioned that at the beginning. That was the second one that was done. And that was obviously the title song that I chose to use today. So that was great. Next, we get to the reissue of I Got Lucky, which was from November 1975. As I say, completely different cover than the one I just showed you. Well, obviously the photograph's the same, but obviously it was in this lovely pink. And then it would be on the RCA Camden turquoise label once again. So there you go. We then go to, and this is one I was talking about. This is one I've played quite recently. This is from October 72. Elvis sings hits from his movies plus two recent hits. This sounds really, really good. Particularly Down by the Riverside. You Don't Know Me. These sound really spectacular. And I think they sound as good as the original releases. In fact, I think the Down by the Riverside, I actually think it sounds better than the original Red Spot RCA Frankie and Johnny. I think it sounds fantastic. I don't have what's coming up next, but I do have it in the American guys, which is Elvis, Burning Love and his hits from his movies. Now this came out in November 72. And so I don't have the UK one. This is the American copy, because what RCA Camden would do is that they would release, they'd have initial release. Say we're talking about 1972, they'd release an original release. Then maybe 1975, there would be a French press of it. Then 1976 or 77, there would be a USA release of it. So there was multiple releases, and that's why I've had to make notes, because obviously because they were budget albums, they were probably able to press and press and press, and that's what they did. But there would be various different titles that would come from different parts of the world. Mainly the three countries would be the UK, the USA and France. So there you have it. But that's the American version. Next, we get on to May of 1973, Elvis Separate Ways. Now, this is one I can remember as a child vividly. I love the, I don't love it so much now, but the image of Elvis, obviously on a highway in America, or motorway as it would be called in the UK. And you can see here, I've got the matching T-shirt, though this is for the American release copy, which I do have. I think I've featured that in another video somewhere, or I will do in the future. As you can see, once again, RCA Camden on the blue turquoise label. And next we have Easy Come, Easy Go. I might have to start rattling through these because bearing in mind this video is going to drag on a little bit. This was from February 1975, mainly his hits once again. Then we have US Mail from June 1975, which is another favourite of mine. I can also remember this very well as a child. And this has got a great selection of songs on it. Also sounds very good. Once again, RCA Camden turquoise label. Now, believe it or not, the next one that was released from October 75, I don't have, which is the Elvis Christmas album. Now, I had it as a child, or my mum and dad had it as when I was a child. The one with the white cover, which I'll put an image up for you. But I don't have it, and I haven't got it because I can't find a really, really good copy of it, particularly with the cover, because the cover, because it's white, it does suffer from age and discoloration. It's one of the probably the most readily available albums that you can find right now. But in the condition that I would want it to be, it's hard to get. Now, they would do an export cover on this in 1981. I think I sold one of these a couple of months ago. I think it went for £30 or £40. It normally goes for a lot more, but it wasn't in the condition that I would have liked it to be. And had it been, I would have kept it. But you can see it was a very different cover from what this October 75 copy had been. And you can see here, there's a picture up of it. But like I say, I don't have it. And I don't have the next two as well, which they were mail order releases only. And they came out in November 1975. One would be called Elvis Presley and one would be called originally Elvis Presley Volume 2. But they consisted of records that had already been released by RCA Camden. They were Separate Ways, Easy Come, Easy Go, and US Mail, which obviously I've already shown you. And then Volume 2 will be You'll Never Walk Alone, Elvis Sings Hits from His Movies, and I Got Lucky. So, you know, they were not adverse to releasing stuff that had already been released, that had already been released before that. So you can see we were getting on somewhat of a treadmill. But, you know, as long as people were going to buy it, they were going to release it. So anyway, next we go to August 1976. We have Elvis Presley, their collection. This would be the first gatefold that we would see. But primarily, this consisted of songs that had already been released again. This consisted of You'll Never Walk Alone and Elvis Sings Hits from His Movies. But there you can see the first gatefold that we would look at. Of late, I've been asked where I get my gatefold sleeves from. If you go to the episode of King Creole, you will find the information there. Not wanting to be rude, I don't want to repeat all the time where the sleeves come from. So, but if you've got a question, yes, I'll answer it in the comments. But as opposed to me keep talking about these sleeves, you will find it in the King Creole edition, and they are really good. Next, we would get to June 1978. And this will be Volume 2. Once again, a gatefold sleeve. Two record set, which would consist of Separate Ways and Easy Come, Easy Go. So you weren't actually getting anything new for your money, but you were getting a gatefold. I've been no different. I've collected them as I've got the single ones as well. And then from April 1979, we've got Please Don't Stop Loving Me. I like this album. It's got some really good songs on it. And of course, we are... This will be a later press. As I said, from 1978. Not a later press, but this will be where we're getting now into the records, or the labels have got Camden on them. So from 1978, there's actually no RCA on the label now. It's purely gone over to Camden. And this would be the... As I say, I think it's... the first one that had it. I don't think it's on that one that we just did before. Let me just have a quick look. No, because that once again would be the RCA Camden. Okay, and next we would be at April 1979, Elvis the Collection Volume 3. Now this consisted of Please Don't Stop Loving Me, and Elvis Sings Flaming Star. Now, these were released at the same time. And that's what I was saying to you about, you know, they would do duplicate releases, exactly the same songs, but in different formats, where you've got a double LP. So you go right back to the beginning, where Elvis Sings Flaming Star, and then we have the latest one, which was Please Don't Stop Loving Me. Not very original, but there you have it. Okay, next we are at, once again, we have two releases at the same time. From January 1980, we have Elvis Double Dynamite Volume 1, and then we have Elvis Double Dynamite Volume 2. And then we would have this also released at the same time, which is... there I say, both albums on a double again. Crazy, I know it's true, but this is what was happening in the late 70s and early 80s. And this one actually came with a poster as well. I'll show you quickly. I'm sure lots of you have this. There you go. Pickwick Camden, Elvis Lives On. Because obviously now we're at the time where Elvis has passed away and we're getting lots of remembrance stuff coming out. You know, why shouldn't we? Because he was the, you know, the greatest artist I've ever known. I just wish they were a bit more careful in these days about stuff that they'd released. Also in January 80, we had Elvis the King. So there had been a plethora of releases at this point. And this was everything from, or some of the stuff was from the 1973 Aloha from Hawaii, the songs that were put into the segments where you see the lady walking along the beach and so on. These were just the additional songs. It would be the first time they'd be available on any type of record, which would be this one, Elvis the King. I like that record. Right, next we get on to two releases that came out in October 1980. Now, these are special because they were only released at a supermarket, very similar to Walmart, I guess you'd have in the USA. But these were released in a supermarket called Marks and Spencer's, as I say, in October 1980. And one would be called Elvis, and one would be called The Wonderful World of Elvis. Now, these were special because they had the red labels. So this is the red label for this one. And then I'll show you the gatefold version, because I'm also very fortunate to own the red label on this one. Now, this was sealed when I got it, but I did open it up because I wanted to always give everything a clean. But these are quite, you know, I say hard to get hold of. They're limited to 10,000. I suppose, you know, they are available, but they're not as common as the blue labelled version, which would be reissued in February 1981. Once again, we're sticking with the Camden label. I don't have The Wonderful World of Elvis on the blue label. I have had it, but I kind of wanted the red one, if I'm honest. Will I get a blue one at some point? Maybe, I'm not sure. But now, that for a cover is a striking cover. And the clarity on this is brilliant. That's why I say, from Camden, you would get, you know, you get the odd gem every now and again. But for me, that is one of my ultimate favourite album covers. I think it's fabulous. Okay, and then we are at January 81. We are at Return to Sender, another favourite cover of mine. I think that's awesome. Obviously from Flaming Star. And then this would come with a poster as well, which I'll quickly show you. Sorry, bearing in mind time is getting on. I don't know if this one's been out. That would be the full size shot of what would be on the front. I don't know if you can see that properly, but I'll pop an image up on screen. Great, great poster. I really would like to put that up one day, but it's having the space and having an understanding partner. Well, I'll put that to one side. Okay, and next we get to two records that would be both released in the same month, August of 1981. It's Now or Never and Heartbreak Hotel. Now, these would come with export covers as well, which I'll pop up on the screen for you. Very, very hard to get hold of. I don't own them. They don't come up that regular for sale. If anyone has got them, congratulations, because I would love a copy of each. But, you know, as I say, people are not really going to let them go because they are very hard to find. Now, also, Heartbreak Hotel, this came as a clear vinyl as well. I'll pop up a picture, but this wasn't sanctioned, or I don't think it was sanctioned by RCA Camden or the Elvis Presley estate. Oh, I don't know if that's right or wrong, but Whether it's a proper release, I don't know, but it does have the Camden label on it. I've never seen one. Is it readily available? Probably not. I hate to think how many there are out there. Probably not that many. But there you go. Those were both released at the same time. And then April 82, we get to Suspicious Minds. Brilliant cover on this. But this would also once again come with an export cover, which I do have. Because this one was a lot easier to get hold of than the other ones that have been released. They were so hard. But this one, as I say, was available. I got this one, no problem. This is in superb shape. We're still at the Camden Turquoise label. Beautiful. I think both covers are really, really good on that. Next, we get to Are You Lonesome Tonight? This also, once again, had an export cover. I like this one as well. Also like the copy I'm showing you on screen right now. Don't have it, never seen one for sale. They come up very, very rarely. And once again, we're at the blue turquoise label. Next we have Can't Help Falling In Love, which was from May 1983. I like this album cover as well. And this has a great selection of songs on. Still at the turquoise Camden label. Next one would be Love Songs from August 83, which I don't have. Now, I thought I had it, but I looked this morning and I just couldn't find it, which was somewhat of a surprise to me. And now we're getting on to the very last couple. Sorry, I won't bore you anymore, but I know there's lots of people that do find this very interesting. Elvis the Legend from October 83. That is a very hard cover to find in great shape. And obviously, once again, because it's white, but that is a really nice copy. Once again, we're not differing on the labels. And then the very, or second last to last one that was ever released on the Camden label, Elvis the First 10 Years. I like that cover as well. From Girl Happy. And once again, blue turquoise Camden label. The very last one which was released, which was the Rock Hits from April 86. I don't have it. I haven't seen it that often. I suppose I should try and hunt it down. And invariably, I will in the future. And then Rainbow Records, they released the Elvis Presley collection, which consisted of Elvis Sings Hits from His Movies, I Got Lucky, Separate Ways and You'll Never Walk Alone. It was a 4LP set and it was shipped to Germany. I have had one and I've sold one probably about 6 months ago. Really, you know, thinking about it, I should probably kept it, but because as I say, they don't come up that often. Anyway, that was a brief history of Camden. You know, no doubt there are some errors in there, or you may have better information than what I do. You know, please share it with me because I'd be interested to know if there's any I've missed out. I almost missed out Let's Be Friends, which was a bit of a schoolboy error, but there you go. I try to do this in one take as I do every week. And there will be times where I do cut to a song, but you know, most of the cutting, because I look at some videos and it's cut after cut after cut after cut, and I don't want to do it like that. I just want it to be free flowing and as natural as possible. So look, you know the score by now. If you wish to subscribe, you know what to do. I'm not going to beg for subscribers. I looked at a few of my last videos, I think, oh, that's what I appear to be doing. I don't want to do that. If you like what you see here, you know what you can do. Likewise, if you don't like it, then, you know, don't feel like you have to put derogatory comments, because it's not necessary. There's enough of that going around in the world. I don't want that on my channel. It's a happy channel. It's about a guy that has brought lots of happiness to me and lots of other people. Let's try and keep it that way. But once again, thank you very much for watching. And TCB, till next time.